Good day, student. As you can see, what we have today is the integration of e raised to the power 2x multiplying cos x dx. You are required to find the value of this integration. So the first thing you have to know is to recognize the which formula or which type of integration you have to use. In this case, we have exponent and also we have trigonometry. I believe this is an example of integration by parts. An integration by parts, IBP for abbreviation, is the integration of u dv, and this gives us uv minus integral v du. So before you go into solving it, we have to make use of the order of selection of the first function. Based on this, the logarithm come first in the order of selection of the first function, which function will be u and which function will be v. That is, which function we have to differentiate, and then which is likely to be u and which function we are likely to do what? Integrate. So we can apply the what? IBP formula. So this logarithm come first, inverse second, algebra third, trigonometry fourth, and exponent last. So in this case, we know that the trigonometry come before exponent, which means cos 3x has to be the u, and e raised to the power 2x dx has to be what? Dv. So we'll rewrite it in this form: cos what? 3x, e raised to the power 2x dx, so that this is u and here is what? Dv. So once you have rewritten it, once you have rewritten the formula, the next thing is to go into solving it. So in this case, we know that u is equals to cos 3x, which means the u is equals to minus 3x, 3 sine 3x dx. So that is it. And for that reason, we know that in this case, dv is equals to e raised to the power 2x dot dx, so that the integral of dv is equals to the integral of e raised to the power 2x dx. So once you integrate both sides of the equation, you have that v is equals to integration of this, will give us e raised to the power 2x divided by 2. So once you have gotten the all you needed to use the integration by part, you now have to substitute it, all of them, in the formula of integration by part. So we have integral e raised to the power 2x dot cos 3x dx is equals to what? U is equals to cos 3x, and v is equals to e raised to the power 2x over 2. So you can rearrange it to give us e raised to the power 2x over 2 multiplying what? Cos 3x minus integral v is equals to what? E 2x over 2. So I can write it first before I bring out the constant, multiplying what? Multiplying the u, and the u is equals to minus 3 sine what? 3x dx. So if you bring the constant out, we have minus 3 over 2. Bringing the constant out, so we can rewrite it. If we write it to have plus, this will give us 3 over 2, and then we can rewrite the expression between the integral formula. In this case, we have what? We have 3 sine 3x dot what? Dot e raised to the power 2x dot dx. So This is how you have to bring the constant out before you integrate the value. So from here, let's concentrate on this integration. Let's integrate the value. So when we do that, we substitute it back to the original equation. Integral sine 3x e raised to the power 2x dx. So in this case, we already know that this is u. Sorry, and this value is dv. We can still apply it what we did before, following this process. So in this case, the u is equals to 3 sine 3x dx. And from here, integral dv is equals to integral e raised to the power 2s dx. So from here, half v is equals to e raised to the power 2x divided by 2. So once you arrive at it, we can now use the formula of we now apply the formula of what? IBP to solve this function. So I can clean here. So let's apply the formula. So integration of this, if you integrate it, you have what? UV. So U is equals to sine 3s and V is equals to e raised to the power 2s over 2. So e raised to the power 2s over 2 multiplying sine 3x. Which one you write first is close. Minus integral, I hope you are seeing it. Minus integral minus integral v, which is equals to e raised to the power 2x over 2 du. So this is our du dot what 3 sine 3x dx. So once you have written it, that is all. So all you need to do is they come to the this equation, and wherever you see sine 3 s e raised over 2 s dx, you put this value. So sorry, when you differentiate this, what do you have? When you differentiate the u, when we differentiate the u, you have to have 3 cos what 3x dx. So that is it. When you differentiate u, you have what? 3 cos 3s dx. So here supposed to be 3 cos what 3s dx. So that is it. In this case, wherever you see this equation, this integral in this here, all you need to do is is to substitute this value for sine 3 s dot e raised to power 2 a dx. Substitute this value. Let's do that. I can clean up and bring the whole thing up, so it will be easy for understanding. So we find that integral e raised to the power 2s cos 3s dx is equals to e raised to the power 2x dot cos 3x divided by 2 plus 3 over 2. Is it not? So plus 3 over 2, and then let me bring my 3 plus 3 over 2. I hope you're seeing it. we find that the integration is of this cos is equals to e raised to 2s cos 3s over 2 plus 3 over 2. I want to substitute this value, this value here, with already values we find downstairs, with this value for sine 3s e raised to power 2x. So substituting it, I can now clean here. If we do it, we have what in bracket 3 over 2 in bracket, you substitute these values, e raised to power 2x dot sine 3x over 2 plus what 3 here, 2 is here, bring it outside, you have 3 over 2 integral e raised to power 2x dot cos 3x dx. So I hope you are seeing it. So once you do that, so that is it. The next thing is to open this bracket and multiply everything in the bracket by 3 over 2. And I have integral e raised to power 2x, hope you are seeing it, cos 3x dx is equals to e raised to power 2x cos 3x over 2 plus. So open bracket and multiply everything in the bracket by 3 over 2. So we have 3 e raised to power 2x sine 3x divided 2 times 2 give us 4 plus 3 times 3 will give us 9 divided by 4. 2 times 2 will give us 4. Integral e raised to power 2x does 3x dx. So notice that e raised to 2s cos 3s dx is equals to e raised to power 2s cos 3s dx. Is it not? So let's there's some little error here. When we differentiate, when we have sine 3x, if you differentiate sine 3x, so if you use the sine, that formula of finding here, this is not plus, this is minus. Remember formula of solving IBP formula, integral u dv is equals to uv minus integral v du. Because when you differentiate sine 3x, if you differentiate sine 3x, when we say du, if you differentiate it, you have 3 what cos 3x, there's no minus. So that's why sine here didn't change. Here is supposed to be minus. If you follow up, so we made mistake there. So that's supposed to be minus. So now notice that this value here is equals to value here. So let minus 9 over 4 integral e raised to power cos 3s crosses equal sign. If you cross this equal sign, it will add up to this value here. In this case, we have integral e raised to power 2x cos 3x dx plus 9 over 4 integral e raised to power 2x dot cos 3x dx. So this gives us what? E raised to power 2x cos 3x over what? 2 plus what 3 e raised to the power 2x sine 3x divided by 4. Any question? Sorry, so divided by 4. So from the left hand side, you can add it. Go to the left hand side here. Add these two equations, you see they are the same. 4 times 1 will give us 4. 4 plus 9 will give us 13. So you have 13 over 4. Integral e raised to the power 2x cos 3x dx. So all these terms are still this term. So the next thing is, since we get through 13 over 4, so what we want to make integral e raised to the power 2x cos 3x this object, which means you have to multiply both sides of the equation by 4 over 3, 13. You have to multiply both sides of the equation by 4 over 13 so that this can cancel out to give us this value alone. So 4 over 13 multiplying all these values. Let's bring it up. So let's do what? Bring it up. So from here we have integral e raised to power 2s cos 3s dx, 4 over 3, 2 over 13 in bracket. These values here, e raised to power 2x cos what? Cos 3x divided by 2 plus, hope you are following, plus 3 e raised to the power 2x sine 3x divided by 4. So you put your what constant of what integration plus what c. So that is the value of the integration. So the integration of e raised to the power 2s cos 3s dx is equals to 4 over 13 in bracket e raised to the power 2x cos 3x divided by 2. Sorry, plus 3 e raised to the power 2s sine 3x over r over 4, and then the constant of the integration. That is the value of the integration. You have any question? So integration of e raised to the power 2x cos 3x dx. Is equals to what? So is equals to that value you see. So this is where we stop. Please endeavor to subscribe to our channel for more videos for your view. Click the notification button so that you'll be notified whenever we update recent videos. Click like and share. Follow us in the next class, and then you will learn more of integration. See you in the next class. Bye for now.